Auctions across Sydney today recorded lower turnouts and fewer registered bidders as the interest rate rise played on buyers' minds. And with the Reserve Bank open to a further rate rise, there could be more pain ahead for the country's home buyers.
5 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms, a car too, but this Regent's Park home passed in at $2.5 million.
All hope is not lost on this one.
It just makes us have to work a little bit harder.
This, the first auction weekend since interest rates were hiked again on Tuesday, today following a familiar pattern.
We certainly have seen a small lull in the number of buyers attending opens and auctions. This is normal every time there is a rate rise. The question is for how long it'll last.
Colleen Harris grew up at this Regent's Park address. It was called Villa Maria then and is unrecognisable and for many unaffordable now.
It's been certainly modernised and I think the whole suburbs, you just look around, the whole suburb's different to what it was.
The 8 registered bidders here today were a mix of locals and those who came from outside the area. The locals say they wanted to keep an eye on what the property market was doing in their suburb. Those who travelled are on a search for value. But no matter where you look, value is hard to find. In Regent's Park, monthly repayments on the average home are up $160. That's $2,270 more than they were in April last year. It's the same story in Penrith, where homeowners are forking out an extra $110 a month. In Miranda, you'll be up for an extra $200. And in Sydney's East, a mortgage on the average Bondi home will now cost you an extra $490 a month.
The consequences of the hikes to date are yet to filter through to most of the economy. The pain that that means it's going to impose on households and other businesses next year, it's not a good outlook for a lot of people.
In Regent's Park, Matt Kennellan, 9 News.